The surge of migrants is posing both a criminal and a health threat to the United States. One prominent doctor in a Texas border town telling Fox an uptick in local COVID cases is, quote, certainly linked to migrants with COVID. This as Immigration and Customs Enforcement agents uncover a 183-foot-long drug tunnel. Agents say it's about 20 feet underground, running from Mexicali, just south of the border, into California. The Democratic mayor of Laredo, Texas, Pete Saenz, joins us now. Mayor, it's good to talk to you. Obviously, drug tunnels are not an issue where you live. Nobody's tunneling under the Rio Grande, as far as I know, at this point. But we see a lot of these tunnels in California. This one apparently did not have an exit on the U.S. side. But what are you seeing down there in the Laredo sector in terms of criminality and criminal enterprise?
Yes, our situation. Thank you for having me, by the way. Our situation here is more directed towards stash houses. The Laredo sector Border Patrol is seeing more single adults coming through our area here. And these single adults are basically organized through the cartels and some local gangs. Luckily, our city is still very safe. But if we don't obtain resources from the Biden administration as soon as possible, or that may change. So these stash houses, basically, it's organized. People are gathered there, and then they're loaded into tractor trailers or even trains leaving Laredo toward the north. And of course, it worries us because if there's criminal activity, there's women, children, guns, money involved. So it's a splendid recipe for something bad to occur.
And as we've seen in recent weeks, lives are involved as well. There was that van traveling with some 30 people in it. It crashed into a utility pole. 10 of the people who were inside were killed. There's also health implications there along the southern border. We hear a lot about McAllen, Texas, because over the course of the year to date, some 7,000 people have been dropped in McAllen who are infected with COVID, 1,500 just about a week ago. Here's what Chris Cabrera, who's the spokesman for the National Border Patrol Council, told us.
You know, it's pretty bad. I know we have at least 80 of our agents, well, more than 80 of our agents have tested positive.
Again, we hear so much about McAllen, Texas. What's the situation there with illegal migrants and COVID in Laredo?
The situation here is that we're taking the overflow. Border Patrol is overwhelmed in the McAllen RGV area, that they're busing migrants to our city to be processed. We've had no other choice but to actually, the city of Laredo proper, basically transporting these folks further north because we can't handle it here. The NGO capacity is very limited. Whatever migrants were being received here would easily create or cause the NGO to be quarantined. And then, of course, Border Patrol keeps on dumping more migrants that we can't handle them. So we're just busing them out.
You know, about a third of the way between McAllen and Laredo is a small town called Rio Grande City. Dr. Antonio Falcone is a physician there. He was asked by Fox News about the surge in COVID cases there in Texas, and he says that a lot of it's coming in from illegal migrants, but it's not just limited to the local areas in Texas. Listen to what he said.
We've had a significant number of new cases show up in our area here and in our practice. But also remember that as those migrants are released and travel north, they continue to be infectious because the CDC guidelines for quarantine and isolation are not being followed. And that's a huge problem.
So we have, Mayor, a huge contradiction here. We've got the Biden administration recommending mask mandates, potentially recommending vaccine mandates. Apparently, according to the AP, the Pentagon is going to require all active duty personnel to get a COVID vaccine by September the 15th. And yet, at the same time, these illegal migrants who have not been tested for COVID, not been vaccinated for COVID, many of whom are COVID positive, continue to flood across the border.
And we see it here. You know, we don't test. Border Patrol doesn't test. You know, they don't have that capacity until, you know, what do you expect from a smaller, you know, entity like the city of Laredo? So basically, these folks are going north. Although we coordinate with NGOs and the emergency management coordinators in those cities that they're traveling, but But, you know, we're doing the best we can with what we have.
So let me quickly ask you this question. Since Jaime Villalobos got elected mayor there in McAllen, he's a Republican, we've been hearing a lot more from officials in McAllen about the situation down there, the message going right to the White House. You are a Democrat, even though your office is nonpartisan. What would you say to President Biden and the White House about all this?
Please send us resources. We've been asking for resources for months now. And by resources, I mean personnel. It's my understanding, too, that the Border Patrol budget for this year was not increased. I think it was lessened. So, you know, we can't go that direction. You know, we need more Border Patrol. We need more technology. We need these migrants to be tested at the border before they travel further north. So that's the sort of things that we need here at the border. But we need relief. You know, we need to secure the border, frankly. And for us, it's... you know, these asylum seekers should be applying from their country of origin or somewhere close, safe places within those countries, but don't force them to come to the border to actually declare asylum.
Got it. I misspoke, shoot, too. It's Javier Villalobos. Mayor Pete Saenz of Laredo, good to talk to you. Best of luck. Let's hope that the White House got the message. We'll see.
Thank you very much, sir.
All right,
appreciate
it. Anita?